Boys and girls, I am so happy to be here. I'm going to tell you one of my favorite stories that was written a long time ago about me by Mr. Clement C. Moore. It's called, "'Twas the Night Before Christmas." "'Twas the night before Christmas, when all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. And the stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. And the children were all nestled, all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. And Mama in her kerchief, and I in my cap, had just settled down for a long winter's nap, when out on the lawn there arose such a clatter. I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter, and away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and threw off the sash. The moon on the breast of the new-fallen snow gave the luster of midday objects below, when what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer. With a little old driver so lively and quick, I knew in a moment it must be St. Nick. More rapid than eagles, their courses they came, and he whistled, and he shouted, and he called them by name. Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer, now Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donner, on Blitzen, and to the top of the porch, and the top of the wall. Now dash away, dash away, dash away all, as dry leaves before the wild hurricane fly, when they met with an obstacle mount to the sky. So up to the housetop the courses they flew, and with a sleigh full of toys, and St. Nicholas too. And then, in a twinkling, I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof. And as I drew in my head, and I was turning around, down the chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound. He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack. And his eyes, how they twinkled, his dimples, how merry! His cheeks were like roses, his nose like a cherry, his droll little mouth drawn up like a bow, and the beard on his chin was as white as snow. And the stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke, it encircled his head like a wreath. Why, he had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed, like a bowl full of jelly. He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself. And a wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know that I had nothing to dread. He spoke not a word and went straight to his work, and filled all the stockings and turned with a jerk, and laying a finger aside of his nose and giving a nod, up the chimney he rose, and he sprang to his sleigh, and to his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a thistle. But I heard him exclaim, and he drove out of sight, "Happy Christmas to all, and to all a good night." Isn't that a wonderful story? I think Clement C. Moore described me perfectly. Even my round little belly. Well, we can blame that on Mrs. Claus's wonderful cooking and all those cookies that you boys and girls leave me. Well, I must be on my way. The elves are probably ready for me to open some more of your Christmas letters so they can keep making those toys. Those little elves work very hard right up to Christmas Eve when I take off with my reindeer to deliver your toys. Keep being the good boys and girls that I know you are, and I will see you very soon. Merry Christmas!